Oh, when I worked with my uncle and he paid me my first gig, $1.25. I said, oh, this is like stealing candy from a baby.
So that was it. That's what turned you on.
$1.25 playing in the Mexican club with a band that it was a typical Puerto Rican band, two uncles in it, and I played timbales. In 1925, my mother arrived from Puerto Rico. My father followed 26. At that time, they were freighters. They weren't cruisers, okay? Then they got married in New York. My brother was born in 27, the great Charlie Palmieri, pianist. And then I was born 9 years later. No other sister, no other brother, so I'm a blessing that I was born. And it was my mother that put us on the piano, my brother and I. That was a dream, you know. She was the seamstress, and my father was an electronic genius, really, with radio and television at that time. Television was just starting. You know, listening to the records that my brother would bring home, that, you know, and then listening to commercial radio and playing stickball in the streets in the Bronx, because I was born in Manhattan, 112th Street between Madison and Park. It's now called the Charlie Palmieri Way. And then we moved to the Bronx around 1941, 42, the break of World War II, and I was raised in the Bronx. Great teachers. Wherever my brother went, I went. My first teacher was Miss Margaret Barnes, B-O-N-D-S. She taught in the Carnegie Hall building. In the top floor, they used to rent out to great teachers, and she was a concert pianist, so she taught piano. My brother was her student, and then my brother recommended me to her. At 11 years old, I used to take the subway and go right to Carnegie Hall, and then I did an evaluation test in the theater next door, the Wild Theater, and I got good marks, and I was very happy about that. Then another teacher called Claudio Savadana. He was a master in the individual finger control, which is beyond any students that I teach. No one has any idea of that. It's unfortunate that the teachers don't know that either, piano teachers. But he taught me something that was very, very important in my life. And he went to Brooklyn College, and he was also the conductor of the church in Harlem, you know, where I was married. Then my main teacher after that became a gentleman in Italian called Bob Bianco. And Bob Bianco took me into the world of Joseph Schillinger, the Russian scientist, and that wrote 12 books and 2 volumes, the masterpieces, the mathematical basis of the arts. And George Gershwin studied with him, Oscar Levant. I mean, where my teacher took me was something straight out there. Plus the harmonic world of jazz, and then plus political economy of Henry George. Henry George was in the late 1800s, he ran for mayor of New York. So it was very, very enlightening what I was able to learn from Bob Bianco, his teaching. And I studied with him for 25 years. Plus he played guitar, and we recorded him also with my band. We had a lot of wonderful moments, yeah. Well, it was an honor because the one who gave me the award was Chick Corea. And he's one of my mentors, you know, one of my dear friend also. And he was with the sister of Carly Simon also, they gave it to me. And it was in the trade building that came down. The floor was the 13th floor, like nobody seen 13 in a floor in a building. And my table was 13, and I was running against six of them. There were seven of us. It was usually five, but two of them came tied. The other six were Fania artists. And I got the award. You should have seen their faces.
What was that like for you? What did that feel like?
Oh, I was elated. Okay. I was elated because I never wanted to be part of the bunch. I always respected them, but I always wanted to be, I was always independent. And I went with a new company that was being formed. So eventually I landed with Pania though in 1980, in which we recorded an album called the White Album, which is it's one of the greatest albums ever recorded, you know, because of the musicianship and who I had playing, and the great singer Chill Feliciano from Puerto Rico, who passed away also. But Fania started in 1964. The great flute player, Dominican, that I learned to play with my brother Charlie Palmieri and his orchestra, L'Orchestra du Bonnet, and in a supper club called the International. So Johnny Pacheco met a gentleman called Jerry Masucci, who was with a policeman, then he became an attorney, and then they got together, they put $2,500 apiece, and they formed Fania. That when Jerry Masucci died, he left $35 million estate. That's a little bit about Fania. The ones that were going in that direction all passed away. I'm like the last of the Mohegans. Nobody left except me. Anecdote about my wife, who passed away. Today's her birthday. She passed away 3 years ago. So she told me, you have no idea how blessed you are. People work very hard to buy you tickets to come and see you perform. So what you have to do is be on time, punctuality is class, and then look as best as you possibly can and practice your trills, you know, and practice. And then she got closer and said, and stop with the jokes, you're not a comedian. I said, okay, baby. That was my girlfriend. We married 60 years, we went out 2 years before that, 62 years together.